Couple of things we need to get out of the way. These are called the advertisements before the entertainment begins. Just like the television at home. Okay. First, I want to draw attention to the friends of Prescott Public Library who make all of these events possible. So we always give them a hand. On the back table, you will see these little pamphlets that are calendars for upcoming events this month. A couple of things you may want to pay attention to. In this very room, this Wednesday, Irma Bombeck will be here in person. And FYI, stay tell your friends. Also in this very room, on Wednesday the 21st, Paula Williamson, America's yodeling sweetheart, will be here in person. If you like Patsy Cline, she bears an uncanny resembles Patsy Cline. And she's not only the yodeling champion of the United States, she's the yodeling champion of the United States twice. Okay. So right here in this room. Also, you will find a little 5x7 back here. This is an evaluation of the program. We take these very seriously. We'd love to have you stop for just a minute, fill one of these out, and give it to me before you leave. Very important. And we're so delighted that you will take a moment and do that, that we what? Let you keep the pencil absolutely free. Okay. So before you leave, stop by and fill these terms out. We really appreciate it. And now, Johnny, if that's your real name.
Southend-on-Sea, which is approximately 40 miles east of East London, and I spent the first 20 years of my life there. I legally left school at the age of 15, and probably about 4 or 5 months later, I started to get heavily involved in the UK punk rock scene, which at the time was still pretty prominent in England. There's a few punk rockers around today, but you know, one type of hair, the Mohawks, and in my case, dirty clothes that were washed, and hanging out with friends in squats at the time, different parts of England in their bedsits. And then 2 days after my 20th birthday, I kind of really had enough of what Mighty Blighty had to offer me at the time. And I thought to myself, you know what, it's really time to start to just get out there, travel the world, and just to see what was really, you know, going on in other parts of the world. And at that time, many of my friends were kind of getting mortgages, having children, even the age of 16 or 17 when I was younger, I was just like, whoa, I'm not wrong with that. I thought there's so much more out there. And when I was a kid, my Uncle David, who was a world traveler at the time, I don't know where he went, but I remember as a child, he'd bring back, like, from Athens, example, like a leather money belt. When he came to the States back in the 70s, I always remember this, you know, he'd bring back a big gold, which you probably would call, roughly 8 because you can remember this, the big old American gold, silver dollar coin. So in the 9.5 to 10 years that I started from when I first started traveling, which was Sunday, July 12th, 1987, I went through probably 10 countries. More specifically, my hitchhiking was around Australia, where I was just talking to a couple of my students, something very similar to myself. But I traveled around Australia, both islands of New Zealand, 42 of the United States, back and forth, up and down, and almost one side of Canada to the other, up to Alaska, etc., etc. And during this time period, with the old, as you all recall, the old 4x6 you know, film back in the day, you get the film, you know, so you get the relatives, so long gone of those days, because it's the modern generation. But I took about 32,000 photographs over the years, and probably 24,000, 25,000 of my travels alone. And 1991, which is approximately 3 to 3.5 years into my travels. I was back home, it was an opposite circumstance for a few months. And I said to myself, you know what? And it's something I think we've all said during our lifetimes, or we've listened to our grandparents tell stories, and you just sit there and treat as a child. And something I've often said to people, in fact, I said it to two people today, you know, why did you write a book about this? Why did you listen to friends, put your memoirs down to your children can learn from it and care for the future generations. And in my case, I think it was more unique in that when I did travel, it wasn't like someone from National Geographic where the plane is paid for, the motels and hotels are paid for when you get there, and you've got the convenience of all that before you start. And you can just basically wake up one morning and refresh yourself, you know, have a shower, and you've got your camera equipment, you can go out to all these wonderful photographs, but everything's all set up for you. In my case, it's very different. About a year after I started traveling, that's when the real traveling started. That was in Australia. And in Australia, you hitchhike with your index finger out, whereas over here, I think it's the same these days, like this, other parts of the world, you wave your hand around and you sign up, whatever it might be. But I think what was unique about my story was the fact that in the, I'd say, probably 8 to 8.5 years I was actually on the road hitchhiking for, I never once told any single person that gave me a ride that I was technically homeless, that I didn't really have a destination unless it was someone somewhere, obviously from the direction I was going, that I was going to stay with. And in the, like I said, the 8 to 8.5 years I was on the road for, I slept about 8 nights. I never once paid for a hotel, never once paid for a motel. And the whole time I was on the road during that time period, the accommodation was given to me from the very people that picked up hitchhiking. And that is what I think was unique about this story. It was just different. And so in 1991, get back to my next point, I had the time for a few months with an opposite circumstance. And back in the era, for those of you that are computer literate, it was a big old, not the small ones, a big old 5-inch floppy here. I mean, you can bend this thing to a little dark, look at that one now, it held very little memory as well for information. And I had a friend who at the time was very expensive, he actually had a computer, and he said to me, Johnny, you know, the keys to my score are yours, and at 5 o'clock in the evening, finished about 6 or 7 in the morning, and I spent months and months just typing out at that point, which the book is about, the first 70 pages are about life, and then page 70 up into, I think it's 27 pages, he goes into his first 3 to 3.5 years of my travels. And I just started to jot down on the computer, my travels. And that was back in 1991. And at that time period, again, I haven't used some expression, but many of you may know, or may have known people who did this, you were like, I think the term was banned in press places, more so in New York, where you give this to you, you know, like thousands of dollars, and you get maybe 100, 500, 1,000 copies of it done. Picked them up at the village house, and basically the whole idea was, it's pretty hard to get published by somebody. You just stuff them in your garage, you pass them to that side, you put the books in there, and you try your best to sell the books to friends, co-workers, neighbours, etc. And the end of my speech is, by getting to the photographs, the advantage over the years, what the technology getting better, computers advancing, with the cell phone, etc. The nice thing today is you've got the term, which I'm sure some of you have heard, print on demand. And you can just literally, like my book is on, they're there, but my book is on Amazon, my book is on Freedom on the Highway, which my mom named many years ago, by myself, which is Johnny Anderson. But these days, I've heard people in England ordering the book on a Wednesday, by Friday morning, it's at their doorstep. Whereas about 20, 25 years ago, it's a big deal to get it sorted out and to wait X amount of weeks to get the book and you can sell them yourself. So that's my little speech, and I'll show you a few pictures. Norma asked me to set this up to get about 30, 35 pictures together. So I'll go for like a little slideshow into your fashion term for it. And these aren't really the best.